Hello, Paco here. In the past year or so, I've become interested in making cordage from blackberry vines. Well, after some experimenting, I finally come up with a technique that I think works really well. So, here it is. Now, there are two things to keep in mind before attempting to harvest the blackberry vines: when you collect them and which ones you try to collect. There's a harvesting season for blackberry vines, and that is usually late spring to mid to late summer, depending on where you collect them. I've been fortunate to find this patch up in the forest that is not dried out yet, but down in the valleys they're way too dry to try and collect. So when you go out to try and collect the blackberry vines, you're not going to be able to collect every one of them. What you're looking for is the younger ones and the wetter ones. Now, you probably won't be able to tell on this video, but this is a younger shoot coming off of a larger one. It's not as prickly, like the prickles break off pretty easily. And if I squeeze this, I can dent it in. In contrast is the vine that's coming off of. This one here, this is an older vine. If I squeeze it, it feels very woody. If I try and pull the cordage off this, it doesn't come off. And so this will not be a good vine to collect from. So what you're going to need for the first stage are three things: gloves, clippers, and a stick. Find yourself a likely blackberry vine, and with the stick, knock off all the thorns. Then with your clippers, come along and just trim off a piece of it. Longer is better, usually. Now, blackberry vines have two layers of bark. There's an outer bark and an inner bark. We're looking for the inner bark. That's the one that makes the good cordage. So we need to eliminate this outer bark. To do that, we pull out our handy-dandy potato peeler, and with the edge of it, we just come along and start scraping the vine. And what you can see is now we have a lighter color one and darker. The darker is the outer bark, the lighter is the inner bark. And we want to get rid of everything that's the outer bark. It also gets rid of the remnants of the thorns as well. You can also do this with the side of your knife, but you have to be careful because you might end up scraping off the inner bark in the process. Now that you've got it all stripped clean of the outer bark, what we do is we just take it and start twisting the vine like this. And what that does is it helps separate the bark, the inner bark, from the woody center. So we're going to go a little further. You can also step on this if this is too much hand strength for you, but then it gets all dirty, so I prefer just to twist it. Now these pieces of inner bark should just pull away from the center. If it doesn't, you can gently tug on it, but they should come relatively easy at this point. If they're not coming easily at this point, you may have waited too late in the season. Here's an example of a blackberry vine that's too dry. So I've got some of the inner bark being pulled off, but I try and peel it, it just comes apart. The blackberry vine is too dry. you can go back and try and find another piece that it comes off easier. Or wait till next year. And now you have this much fiber from that core right here. Now you don't need this anymore, so get rid of it. Now you can start to prepare this into cordage at this point, but it is still relatively thick stuff. And so there's a way to break this down into individual fibers. So to do that, I'm going to pull out my handy dandy dog comb, and I will set it right next to the fibers like so, and start combing it. In weaving terms, this is called heckling the fibers. So I am heckling with my dog comb. And what this does is it makes the fibers finer to give a finer weave to make it work better in some situations. Now this is an optional step. It's not required. It just depends on how coarse you want the fiber when you're done. Quite often I skip the step if I just want some basic cordage that I don't care how rough it is. But it does make it a nice fine fiber when you're done. Now there are various techniques from here which you can do to actually turn it into cordage. One method is just to twist it like so, lay it against itself, and then twist and turn, twist and turn. You need to twist the individual strands one way and twist the entire section, the entire mixed piece together the opposite direction. But there are plenty of tutorials of doing stuff like this online, so just go ahead and look at other videos to see what you can do with the fibers. And here you have some cordage made from blackberry vine. This is just a basic double twist method. I'm sure there's a name for it, but I just don't know. And just how strong is this blackberry fiber? Well, a gallon of water weighs about 8 1/3 pounds. I'd say it's pretty darn strong. Okay, that's it for this time. Till next time.